لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سوى.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين. أحمدك ربي على كل قضائك وجميع قدرك، حمد الرضا بحكمك لليقين بحكمتك، وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقك ونور عرشك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أجمل منك لم تر قط عيني، وأحسن منك لم تلد النساء. خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب، كأنك خلقت كما تشاء. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على أشرف الخلق وحبيب الحق المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters Islam, respective viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to our program. First of all, let us make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless and grant barakah to those who are getting married on this weekend. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them rizqun halalun tayyib. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them together under the hidayat of Allah. May Allah grant them, inshallah, happy children, and inshallah, healthy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase the ummah through them, inshallah. Our congratulations for those who are getting married. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them, inshallah. On behalf of my cameraman, my sound engineer, all our friends behind the camera here, we say nikah mubarak. May Allah accept, inshallah. May Allah make it easy for those who are unmarried to marry, inshallah. Shukran jazilan, and I apologize because these people here on the studio put a very heavy light on my eyes. So it's very hard to open my eyes now on the camera. So forgive me for any error or any mistake, inshallah. Quranic words. And our program today, it's about Muslims and Quran. Sometimes you find the Quranic words, it's such amazing words as a sound. That musical word, tune there on the Quran, or that lovely words, you enjoy it in the Kalam of Allah. We know that we have Quranic Arabic and we have business Arabic, or that Arabic literature. Our Quran, it's a language. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala put some vocab and some words on the Quran. The Arabs, it was a miracle. It was a challenge for the Arabs as well. Very simple, like the hadith of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Very simple words, but you can talk a lot and you got deep meaning. So Kalam of Allah, the words of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, and when Allah says some Quranic words, we as a people who involve on language and we try to dig down and find that the deep meaning of the Quranic words, we got shocked because we even never reached the end of this type of meaning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to get the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quranic words is like a piece of diamond. Got so many angles and so many reflection. So you look at it from this way, you look at it from this way, you got different shining and glooming. And I always look at the kalimatul Quran al-Kareem, I find it, the word itself is a miracle. The way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it, it's amazing words and vocab. The scholars, you know, the Quran, you got the Quranic subject next to the Quran al-Kareem. You got calligraphy, you got tafsir, you got grammar, you got so many type of science. They call it ulum al-Quran, the science of Quran al-Kareem. Why I'm saying that? Because some people, Muslims, they love one surah, and they love one ayah. And then also they love one word, they like it, they want to keep repeating it. You find your heart attached with that word. Another thing also, Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, when he looked at the Qur'an al-Kareem, he said to the people, ثَوِّرُوا Quran, blow, dig down, and try to put your hand down to find the treasure of Qur'an al-Kareem. ثَوِّرُوا, it means to blow, and to find a real meaning of that Quranic words. We got the one there outside one. So we look at the surface, we find the people when you go to the sea, they look at the surface of the water. You see nice waves, nice sunset on the water like this. Another one like to dive down to find the creation of Allah underwater. So Quranic words is very important for all of us to know, and I do appreciate many of our friends, they want to know more. When we talk about tafsir and stories in Quran, I love that expression when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it, that phrase, that ayah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it, and you enjoy. Looking at the word, you get reward. Tadabbur, thinking deeply about the meaning of Quran, it's once you know one ayah like this, is equal to alf raka'ah, equal to the reward of 1,000 raka'ah, you make salah with it. Now we'll go for the words which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Quran al-Kareem regarding those who been cursed or rejected. Reject is reject, like you say, A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Rajim is a rejected. But in Quran al-Kareem, you find that word rajim come in different forms and different type of words. Come and see this laum. Laum, it means blaming. Laum is وَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ. What is lawama? It's that nafs, that ego in yourself blaming you why you did this, and you feel guilty after that. But what about when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blamed that shaitan al-rajim on the day of Qiyamah? Malaika blamed the shaitan al-rajim, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he described the shaitan that he will get a laum, and the shaitan himself will receive that laum from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's called laum, blaming the person. Maluman madhura. Maluman, it means you will be blamed, the sinner, the kuffar, the disbeliever, Allah will blame them. But when that blaming doesn't help, because after the decision of Allah done on the day of Qiyamah, you can blame or not blame it, just a regret and sorrow, but for no benefit at all. And then we got something called madhmuma. What is madhmuma? That person will yaslaha madhmuma madhura. What is madhmuma? Shaitan is madhmum. It means expelled. You are not with the group of the believer. And we did see in our life that someone expelled the government or the rules of the country say, when you do that, we expelled you, we deport you from the country. We expelled you from that community. We don't like you. Get out of here. Very bad feeling when someone in a meeting, with someone in a gathering on the street, and you find the community kick him out. It's very bad. Why? Because he doesn't live with harmony. He's not accepted by this. So you find in Islam, a single man, when you commit zina, you lash him or you send him away a year. Why? Expel him. That's why we said that's called madhmuma. We have something, it's called sab. What is sab? Sab is to show the faulty on someone, is to mention the faulty of someone. That is not accepted in Islam. Faulty, you just try to dig down and find the faulty of someone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Sibab, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sibabul Muslim Fusuq. When you find faulty on a Muslim, especially the image or the physical appearance of the person, that is called transgression. Is not accepted in Islam. Why? Because when you criticize something, ask the mother, when you tell your baby is ugly or is short or like this, mother get very angry. That's why we said you can't make sibab. Sibab, many people think that it's swearing. No, it's not a swearing. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Don't criticize the religion in the ugly way of the other religion. Ugly way, because فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Then they will come and insult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowing, without realizing. So that it's called sab. Sab, we're not allowed to criticize or try to mock and tease the creation or any form of something, even the animals or any type of creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One lady, she met another lady, and that lady was dark complexion, black. And I don't know, in South Africa, yeah, we have a problem with mentioning the words called black. And I got some friend here, you say, why are you mentioning color? Even my children in the school, when I tell them, do you have a white teacher or black teacher, say, daddy, don't be racist. I said, the way I learn that color is no problem at all, as we see the red and brown and white, and we got another color called black. And they say, no, don't talk about color. Yeah, but there is in the list color, and proudly black. And Adam alayhi salam was black, and Nabi Musa alayhi salam was black. What's wrong with that? He said, no, you mustn't mention the color at all. I said, no, I'm not, I don't mean that. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, amongst the beauty of the creation of Allah, there is color. And there's no difference between any other color, illa bit taqwa, as the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that lady met black women and told her, you're so black. So the lady told her, are you mocking me or you're mocking my creator? It means, you got a problem with the paint or the painter? Like when you criticize the chair, are you hurting the chair or the carpenter who fixed the chair? So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala put the wisdom on the tongue of this girl, and the lady makes istighfar and says, sorry, because she don't understand. That's called asabiyya, tribalism, racism, that you treat person according his color or his language or his appearance like this. So that it's called sab. The other thing, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save me and you, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala warn me and you not to get involved on something is called rami. What is rami? Accuse one of your family of zina, man or woman. الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ. So how come you accuse that person of zina, adultery? It's very difficult to prove it. Very difficult. Because a woman is not allowed to be a witness of zina. And even if she saw that action of zina, we don't count it. Why? Because it's very hard to talk about it. It's very hard. And how did you see, and why you are there? Who sent you there to see? You're not allowed to spy someone and to get him. That's why we said, never get involved on rami. Rami is very major sin when you accuse someone of fornication or that zina while you don't have a proof, and you people must get four witness udul. And we did talk about that on the program in Surah An-Nur. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save our tongue from any evil of the tongue, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we say shukran that you're tuning to our program. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah rabbul izzah tabarak wa ta'ala grant shifa to all our brothers and sisters. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for those who are facing some medical problem or that some sickness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save them, inshallah, and may Allah grant them speed recovery. Brother Muhammad Adam and Sister Rahma Adam and Brother Wasim Adam and all our friends who are asking for dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant speed recovery to their father and each and everyone who's ill at home in the hospital, inshallah. May Allah grant shifa, inshallah. Today we're talking about the Quranic words which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it in Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use such a word for a deep meaning so that can cover that need of the understanding. Another word is called taqbih. Taqbih, it means وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ هُمْ مِنَ الْمَقْبُوحِينَ. In the day of qiyamah, they will become amongst those who are maqbuhin. What is maqbuhin? Someone who got a bad reputation. Someone who got a very ugly, faulty, so that it become a problem, become a shame and disgrace for the entire family. When we say that, it means everyone wants to stay away from that person. And unfortunately, in our lifetime, we find some people already accepting themselves by that bad reputation. And he's happy that he's a mafia, or he's an adulterer, or he's a gambler, or someone who is a drunker, or some thought of that. we as a Muslimin, we have to make taqbih for the ugly act, but we don't make taqbih for the person himself. We insult and we disagree with the action of the person. Let's say that person is involved on alcohol. So we hate alcoholic people, but we don't hate that person personally. No, if he gave up and he stopped, is our brother and we love him. If that person drink alcohol and die tomorrow, or he gets sick, we got a problem, we have to go and help him. That's why we be careful of that word. The people, they call it curse, la'na, curse is there in every religion. There is curse from Allah to the person or to the thing, curse from angels, curse come from prophet and messengers, curse from the people, curse from the creation of Allah. So the curse is there in every religion. You find la'na, they call it la'na, chasing away from the mercy of Allah. Sometimes you wish for the person to have curse, or the person doesn't feel that he's cursed, but he is cursed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us that we have become from amongst those who been cursed. After you curse, or Allah curse, it's very difficult to get benefit from that person till he gave up that act which caused that curse to him. For example, if you want to curse, or if you curse your animal, very difficult to get benefit from it, because if it deserve curse and you curse it, there's no khair and barakah on it. The other thing also, we curse the act, not the person. We curse the act. We don't try to personalize that act, that curse or that act of curse. For example, we curse what Allah curse, or what Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cursed, the act of the person. For example, if you find that person with a name, and that person with a name, this one, they're doing all haram. We don't curse that so and so, and curse. We curse those who doing act of that haram. For example, Yahud and Nasara, the Jews and the Christian. We don't curse all of them, and we don't curse Mr. John and Mr. Michael. We curse those who associate partner with Allah. Now the Christians say, no, we don't associate partner, so why you worry? We curse those who associate partner with God, so why you worry? It's not you, so it's fine. The other thing also, we curse those who commit sodomy. But why you curse? I'm saying those who commit sodomy. If you don't do, it's finished. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, la'ana Allah man amala amala qawm Lut. So Nabi Muhammad, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, curse from Allah for those who commit that act of people of Lut, Nabi Lut alayhi salam. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that don't curse those who don't deserve curse, because it's going to come back to you. So it's not easy to curse the person. You must make sure that this one deserve the curse. That's why we said to the brother and sisters, please don't curse your children, because mother, when she curse, it will happen. Oh, don't curse some animal or some act, because it will happen. It will happen. The other thing, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala curse those who break the promise. Promise with Allah, promise with people. So we don't say who, what's his name. We just curse those who break the promise. So that's why everyone must avoid to break the promise. Another thing, anyone who commit a murder that is being cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an ayah in Quran al-Kareem. That those وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا, whosoever kill a person deliberately, فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمُ خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَلَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ, he will remain on the fire of Jahannam, and he got the curse of Allah, وَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. It's like that. So it's very difficult now to clean that person from the curse. Only himself can clean himself from that curse by making tawbah and regret and become on qasas. Then those who mocking Allah and His Rasul even is as a joke. So someone mocking Allah, it means Shariat of Allah, or Rasul is mocking the Sunnah. It's very serious. Never ever criticize and mocking any act which done by sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and act done by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You got ayah here that when you make jokes, Allah said, أبي الله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون. You're mocking Allah in the verses of Allah and the Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed this type of people, but not names, that act of the people. Some of Yahud and Nasara, some of the Jews and the Christians, not all of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed those who break the family ties, but we don't name them. Everyone mustn't break his family ties. He must join his family ties. So when Allah put the curse in Quran, it's a warning for me and you to rectify ourselves and to fix that problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed those who suppress the knowledge, any type of knowledge. This is my secret, my secret. You ask me about something I know and I don't want to say it. That will gain the curse. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ أُولَٰئِكَ يَلْعَنُهُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَلْعَنُهُمُ اللَّاعِنُونَ. Not only Allah, all the creation of Allah, those who suppress the knowledge. Spreading the fitna. What is fitna? You're causing a friction amongst the ummah. Actually, we don't curse, we stop them physically. We can't get one person come to cause a problem, to disunity amongst the Muslim ummah or amongst the society. No, that one here, we don't curse also. We go and stop him physically. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse those who accuse the others of zina, committing adultery, but he doesn't have a proof. That one, الَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ لُعِنُوا فِي الدُّنْيَا. Allah cursed them on dunya, and we curse them, like someone was accusing Aisha radiallahu anha in zina or about zina. Those who criticize and speak bad about sahabat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, muhajirin and the muhajirin, and those who cursing Ahl al-Bayt, the family, the descending of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people being cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because these people, they stand against the wish of Allah. Radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. The Sahaba accepted by Allah. So why? Who are you to stand up and to accuse one Sahabi or to criticize one Sahabi? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Mal'oonun man la'ana walidayh. Curse for those who cursing their parents. How you curse my parents? You curse someone's parents and he curse your parents back. So who's starting that boy? Who's offending? Who's trying to cause that la'na to his father? When you start to curse the other people's his father. Mal'oonun man wasama hayawan. Curse of Allah for those who torturing the animal. May Allah save us from that. Wasama, it means you just put mark on the animal. I'm not talking about coloring. I'm talking about cutting the tail, cutting the ears, or make some changing the, oh, he stamp, or burn the animal with fire, or put some marks there. That is not allowed. But not the hair of the animal. I'm talking about the physical organs of the animals and a part of the body of the animals. لعن الله من ادعى لغير أبيه. May Allah curse the one who said to his parents, you are not my father. Very, very terrible sin, which also we don't like you to get involved in it. I'm still talking about the la'na. The Quranic words called la'na, curse. So Nabi Muhammad said, never ever utter this word that my father, you are not my father, or you are not my mother, because you claim that you are illegitimate child. Another thing, لعن الله النامصة والمتنمصة. Curse of Allah upon those women who are removing the eyebrow for herself or for someone else. نامصة and متنمصة. نامصة is the doer, the متنمصة the receiver of this action. That is a warning for those who work in the hair salon or those who put makeup for the women. Never ever remove the eyebrow. You must ask the Mufti how you deal with this one, how some women remove that eyebrow, put it somewhere, try to change the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They ask me to stop for short break. We'll continue after the break, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. Shukran jazilan that you tune into our program. On behalf of my cameraman and all our friends behind the camera, We say shukran jazeelan that you're tuning to our program, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to pass the message of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Brother and sister in Islam, today we are talking about the words of Quran and Kareem and how much knowledge we can get from one word and how much understanding we can get from one word. I'm very proud of my Quran. I'm very happy that we are following the Kitab of Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us that Quran and that words of Quran Kareem so that we can enjoy our religion. And وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, we recited, and أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ, don't they think deeply about the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know that we have قِرَاءَةُ التِّلَاوَةِ, a recitation with tajweed and qiraat, and we have recitation of Quran with understanding, and the message of Quran Kareem is there, very simple and easy. قَدْ يَسَّرْنَاهُ لِلذِّكْرِ, we ease it to remember it and to say it and to read it. Before the break, I was talking about the la'na, the curse, and how many rules based on that word is called curse. And curse in dunya and akhirah is very terrible way. We don't want to be cursed in dunya, because someone is expelled from the company, expelled from his school, expelled from his society. You feel very bad. What about when that person expelled, mal'oon in the day of Qiyamah, mal'oon, if Allah cursed someone, who's going to stand for him? Who's going to help? He's already expelled from mercy of Allah. Which Nabi is going to stand and help him? Never ever get involved on curse or do action to gain that curse or to obtain that curse on the day of Qiyamah. Number one, the next one, I was talking about la'anallahu namisa wal mutanamisa. Curse of Allah upon the woman who removed the eyebrow or doing for herself or for someone else. Riba, interest. Curse of Allah for 10 people involved in riba. The one who write it, the one who witnessed it, the one who do it, the one who receive it, the one who gave it. You got that one. And then, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ الْمُتَشَبِّهِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ بِالنِّسَاءِ وَالْمُتَشَبِّهَاتِ بِالنِّسَاءِ بِالرِّجَالِ. May Allah curse the man who's imitating the act of women, and may Allah curse the woman who's copying and imitating the act of men. Man is man, woman is woman. So nowadays they call it unisex clothes fashion, or they try to confuse the children. You go to the shop now, clothes shop, and you don't know if this one is for men or women, because you got so many confusion about that. The children now say, mommy, is that trouser for you, for my daddy? So now, when we talk about the woman who's acting like a man, not only clothes, their behavior and attitude. You are women, you are she, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you, the beauty of the women to be women, and the beauty of men is to be a man. But nowadays, the people now, everyone want to play the role of the others. So you said, who's the man of the house? Who's the man of the house? Who's the man, and where's the duty of the man, and where's the duty of the woman? So be careful of acting like a man or woman for that insan. The next one, Nabi Muhammad SAW said, مَلْعُونٌ لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الرِّمَايَةَ فِي حَيٍّ. Curse of Allah for those who learn shooting in a living being. You have gun, you have arrow, you have any type of throwing thing, and you learn how to shoot with a living being. No, living being, when you hunt, you hunt. Don't try to learn on a living being. You must buy the toy or some symbols. The other thing, Nabi Muhammad SAW said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ مَثَّلَ بِالْحَيَوَانِ. Curse of Allah for those who torturing the animals. The way, إِذَا قَتَلْتُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا الْقِتْلَةِ. If you want to slaughter or to kill, you must kill in a merciful way. You can't torture animals. May Allah forgive. غَيَّرَ أَوْ سَرَقَ عَلَامَاتِ الطَّرِيقِ. You got two narration. Curse of Allah, the one who steal the road signs. You know, you find that road there is city this way, left, right. Some people steal it and use it. And in a short way, public property, the road signs. Oh, غَيَّرَ. غَيَّرَ is to turn it. It was stop. You turn it this way or right, you make it left. Cursing is a big problem. And we have to understand that the seriousness of the adab. لَعَنَ اللَّهُ هَاجِرَةُ فِرَاشِ زَوْجِهَا. Curse of Allah for the women who migrate and left the bedding of her husband. Women not allowed to leave the bed. You can fight as you like, which is not Islamic as well, but never leave the bedroom. We see now the lady go to the children's room or to sleep on a lounge or to go to the other room and to punish the husband. Or sometimes women leave the house and go to her father's house. This lady doesn't understand that this act, it's causing la'na. You fight her, but never leave the bed of the husband. And they say, you know, the husband and women must sleep on one bed, must sleep on one, with one blanket, not two blanket. Our Nabi said like that, for so many reasons. Inshallah, we'll talk about it later on. Mal'oon, la'ana Allahu man ashara li akhihi bi hadida. Curse of Allah for the one who threatening his brother with a piece of steel, iron. Try to terrorize him with a plastic gun, with a knife, whatever they did. It's called causing the la'natu of Allah. La'ana Allahu ar-rashi wal-murtashi wal-rash. Curse of Allah for the one who give a bribery, the one who received the bribery, and the one who passed the bribery, that to get something. It's bad. That's why we said to you, try to avoid the act of la'na, because it's mentioned in Quran and Hadith a lot. So, brother and sister in Islam, Quranic words got so many and so many meaning. Plus, there is rules, there is Sharia based on that Quranic words. Another thing, when we talk about Wallahu wasi'un alim, that is another Quranic word, very, very important for us. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stretched the rizq of the people, provide the rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wasi'un alim, all wide and alim, all knowing. Tawsi' wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My mercy can fit anything. So wa inna la mawsi'un. Indeed, we will stretch, we will make it wider. What is wider here? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take something from a narrow place, make it so big and extend it. What is that? You see the baby from the stomach of the mother, how he come out. That is miracle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tied some people in their life, in the rizq, the sustenance, and then from that little child, the rizq and the ni'mat come to the entire family and the entire society. We got Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran al-Kareem is wasi'a. Quran is wasi'a, as we talk now. You just get one word, you can build up a bayan, a talk about one word, like the way we're talking today. Sharia, Islamic law is wasi'a, can accommodate any problem. Just talk about, ما فرطنا في الكتاب من شيء. We never neglect a single rules in the Quran al-Kareem. Another thing, wasi' it doesn't mean it's not there. The thing, when Allah stretched it, it doesn't mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stretched the rizq. It was piled, it was peace, and then Allah spread it like the rain. It was one ice, one cloud, and Allah spread it down. So many plants and animals can get from it. Another thing also, when you have the Quran al-Kareem, we have something is called rahab. We say marhaba, marhaba. What is marhaba? Marhaba, place was narrow, but now we give you accommodation. It's enough for you. When you talk in Arabic and you say marhaba, marhaba. What is marhaba here? It come from the word is called rahab. What is rahab? The place was narrow and then you give a place. It's figurative talk, this one. When we talk about rahab, you got big house, but there's no marhaba there. No visitor allowed to enter. People, they don't talk to each other. People don't want to see the face of each other in that big house, many rooms like that. And the lady ran away from that palace, don't want to live on that place. And then land, homeland, country, country sometimes become narrow for two people. So you say, either you leave or I leave. Oh, that's called la marhaban biko. No welcome. There's no place. We can't accommodate you. So why are we saying marhaba in Arabic? Means my friend, even if my place is narrow, but there is place for you, come, you will fit in that place. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this earth marhaba. Anyone can live like we live here in South Africa. We call it Rainbow Nation. There is marhaba, there is welcoming for anyone. You can come and live. You can find different color, different race, different religion, different school of thought. You find that country is called Murahaba. And that's why we say this person, you got Rahib al-Sadr. In Arabic, we call it like this. Rahib al-Sadr, it means he got no problem with the people. He can live with any race. He can talk with any age. No problem. Don't have any enemy at all. And then we got Qabr, Rahib. Rahib. Allah extend the grave. The grave will be a size of your eyesight. So it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open and widen the grave of the person. Allah, wallahu wasi'un alim. Allah is such a great Allah. He will accept any type of tawbah, any type of act, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you accommodation on Jannah with marhaba. May Allah make it easy for all of us to have that rahib in dunya and akhirah, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. Shukran jazeelan for your comment, for your emails, WhatsApp and phone calls. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah benefit us from ITV, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use ITV as a guidance and road of hidayah, inshallah. I'd like to say shukran to all our viewers, those who study Arabic. May Allah make it easy for you, inshallah, and you learn the Quranic Arabic so that you can understand the Deenul Islam and you understand the message of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Today we are discussing the Quranic words, and I want you, when you get attached with Arabic words, you go to dictionary and you go to tafsir and translation, and you see the deep meaning of these words so that you can love that word and understand the message of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Inna rabbaka wasi'ul maghfirah. We talk about stretching. That word's called wasi'a, wasi'a. Indeed, your Lord has a wide forgiveness. Wasi'a kursiyuhu samawatu al-ard. Accommodate the chair of Allah, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can fit the sky and earth. They say that the chair, the only the food rest of the chair. Inna rabbaka wasi'ul maghfirah. Indeed, your Lord has a huge forgiveness. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that forgiveness and the method of forgiveness, it's unbelievable. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma ghfir li ummati. But he never tell us like through what, how. He said, no, you will find yourself forgiving, but you don't realize, you never notice it. So, inna rabbaka wasi'ul maghfirah. When? We don't know. How? We don't know. And which way? And for who? We don't know. So, ummati, ummati, ummati. Nabi Muhammad said, well, Allah forgive my ummah. But he never tell us how Allah forgive us by any type of sin. The light goes off. You are forgiving. You eat and you say Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah 3 times, you are forgiving. People talk bad about you, you are forgiving. Get fever, sickness, you never complain, you are forgiving. Looking at the face of your mom with mercy, you're getting hajj, you are forgiving. So, wasi'ul maghfirah, you don't know why. If you don't gain that si'at of maghfirah, you're an unlucky person. So, rahmatullahi wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My mercy can accommodate and fit anything. Right. Shafa'atul Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma ghfir li ummati. Oh Allah, forgive my ummah. But he never tell us the details like what he said. Don't worry, Allah will fix it like this. So, si'ah, it means accommodate any type of sin, can fit any type of sin, any type of person, even the kufr. The person was disbeliever and become Muslim now, la ilaha illallah, his story got end. Istighfar, istighfar. You ask Allah to forgive you, but you don't ask him how and when. You just say, oh Allahumma ghfirli, Allah will deal with it like this. Allah is kareem. Allah is very generous. He's the most generous. What? He loved to forgive you, and he created situation. He put you in some situation. you will be forgiving without noticing it. All right. Asking Allah 60 times, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Allah will forgive 600 sin a day. Now you say Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, you gain 600 sin will be forgiving. And Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Ta'isa wa khab, unlucky person, the one who commits 600 sin a day. That person is unfortunate. And then Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala ask million of people to ask you, to ask forgiveness for you. You're sitting at home and you find 3 million haji, hujjaj. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Do you find yourself are forgiving by the dua of someone? You know how many Muslims here? 3 billion people. And then they ask after every salah, oh Allah, forgive al muslimina wal muslimat. You think that one dua won't be accepted? One? You are lucky because we are making dua for each other, but we don't realize that Allahumma ghafir lil mu'minina wal muslima wal mu'minat wal muslimin al ahya, those who are alive and those who are dead. So you sit at home, you receive the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We got istighfar from the creation of Allah. The learned of deen, the students who study deenul Islam, the stone, rocks, animals, birds, fish on the sea, all the creation of Allah, asking Allah to forgive him. So you think that you won't get it, you won't get it. You're sitting on a gathering like our program now. You talk about Allah and His Rasul. You are forgiving. You are forgiving. They call it Majlis al-Dhikr or Riyadh al-Salihin. Reading Surah al-Ikhlas, Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad, that you read this Surah al-Ikhlas 50 times, Allah forgive you 50 years. So just read 50 times. For every time you Allah forgive you 1 year. Look at this ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I just want to prove to you that inna rabbaka wasi'ul maghfira. I just want to prove to you that word is called wasi'ul maghfira. Entering the market, the shopping center, free market, tuck shop, that small shop, that person who sell on the corner there, selling sweet. You just come closer to him. And you read the dua of dukhul al-suq, dukhul al-suq. The dua when you're entering the bazaar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you million sin and give you million reward. Look at this one. How many times we go to the shop or to the bazaar or to buy something. And some sahaba used to go to the market. And you ask him, why you are here? You are not selling and buying. He said, to give salam and to get the reward of dukhul al-suq, the entering the suq. Right. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, whosoever look at the sky with eyes of ibadah, when you look at the sky and say, subhanallah, Allah, Allah will forgive you. Sneeze. You say, alhamdulillah, you are forgiving. Shaking the hand of each other, that Allah forgive two of you. Waiting for salah after salah, you are on salah, you gain the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then seeking knowledge. Seeking knowledge, it's the greatest ibadah, even if it's one ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. Allah forgive a lot. وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنَّ لَهُمْ قَدَمَ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. You know, normally when we read this verse, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا. But this ayah here, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, not عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Just believe like this. أَنَّ لَهُمْ قَدَمَ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. They will have a favor from their Lord. They will have a surprise in their Lord. The person, the day of Qiyamah, he won't believe that is his reward. Because you say, oh Allah, I don't deserve it. He said, no, you've done something, but you didn't realize it. Dua an dhahr al-ghayb. What is dua an dhahr al-ghayb? To make dua for the person in his absence, behind him, is not in his present. Even if you are transgressor, you are not pious enough, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from you for him, and you will get the same. So Malaika said, Allah has accepted from you, and you're getting the same. Look at, I'm just talking about inna rabbaka واسع المغفرة. رزق, رزق في الله سبحانه وتعالى. The sustenance, the رزق في الله سبحانه وتعالى. Look at this آيات here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he said وَيَنْشُرُ رَحْمَتَ, Allah spread his mercy, either the rain or the rizq. You get rizq some way and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to you as one shot or gradually, slowly, slowly, slowly. Sometimes you see the people of deen and knowledge, they don't have enough money. And then anyone who serve Quran, who serve deen Islam, must get rich through himself, through one of his children, one of his lineage. You must get rizq. Khadim al-Quran, the servant of the Quran al-Kareem. And then baraka, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you see, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Tabarak here is not a verb, is not a noun, is not an adjective, it's just a dua. Tabarak, like subhan. Tabarak, it means dama ata'uhu, his give, baraka. Like people call it blessing or baraka. All of us as a Muslimin, baraka of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Because he came and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Me and you and million of Muslims came to this world. It was a baraka of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Imam al-Bukhari, rahmatullahi alayhi. Many ulama, a baraka of the effort of Sayyidina Imam al-Bukhari. Why? He was not an Arab. But the teaching and the knowledge of Imam al-Bukhari is like a live person. If you say the hadith without mentioning Bukhari, people fight with you. So look at the barakah of this one. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, in 10 years, he done something the Roman Empire couldn't do it in 500 years. Why? This is barakah. You see, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you barakah, blessing. Not quantity, quality. The ikhlas of that. So when we say, may Allah give you long life. What do you mean by long life? Everyone has got appointed time to go fix age. He said, no, may Allah grant you barakah on your life. That wife of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma atil umra zawji. Oh Allah, give my husband long life. He said, bal quli, Allahumma barik fi umri zawji. Oh Allah, give barakah on the lifetime of my husband. What is barakah? You live as you like, but you got barakah, you got an effect, you have some benefit. Muslim, sometimes he live for himself, and sometimes he work extra for himself and his wife and children, and for his family, and his society, extended a little bit, and then for his country, for neighboring country, for the whole dunya, like the ulama and sahaba, they were not selfish. They did work for the entire human being. Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab, the first man who fixed road for the animals. So you say it's called barakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you barakah. So can't you take that barakah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a blessing of the world, and you live for the others, you try to be effective for the others, be fruitful for the others. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, oh Allah, grant us the barakah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and oh Allah, grant us the barakah of Quran, barakah of deen. May Allah give us barakah so that we can live for deen al-Islam and for the people. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend our barakah after our death, inshallah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, go to Quran and enjoy that Quranic words and feel these words and think deeply about this word. May Allah reward you. Once you get the ayah with such meaning like this, you get a reward of alf raka'ah, 1,000 raka'ah in your salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us barakah. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا لهم درجات عند ربهم ومغفرة ورزق كريم صدق الله العظيم شكرا جزيلا till we see you inshallah next time. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.